Howdy, howdy, everybody. This is Jared Sterrett, and you're listening to KZCC LP 106.1 Conroe and KZCW LP 104.5 in Conroe and worldwide at ourlonestar.com. Today's music.
Good morning, Montgomery County. 10 o'clock here on Lone Star Community Radio. We are here usually on 9 o'clock a.m., but we had some personal business to attend to. And, yeah, we're here. We're broadcasting live on Facebook Live on Mornings of Lone Star. Check out at Lone Star Community Radio also. And then we're on Conroe's FM 104.5, 106.1, worldwide at irlonestar.com, streaming app on your phone, and also website. And don't forget, we podcast every show for our YouTube video podcast and also iTunes and Google Play. Today's show partners are Clean Sweep Office Cleaning, Conroe Coffee, which is Bean Punk now. So Bean Punk Coffee.
Bean Punk.
And then C3. I'm letting you do that one.
C3, Content Creations.
Yeah, I need to write that one down.
Right.
Write it down.
Write it down.
All right. So we were hanging out downtown Conroe. The studio is pretty much almost done. We're going to start Studio B here in the coming weeks. But downtown is shifting, and changing. This morning, we won't have a guest. So you can be our guest. Comment us on Facebook. Call in and leave a message at 936-647-3776. Or, Whatever. We're going to talk about all sorts of things, catch up, because we haven't been on for a couple days. And then we'll also go over what's going on for the rest of the week. If you missed last night's Conroe downtown Christmas tree lighting, too bad for you. There's great videos on social media. Big crowd. Very happy.
Were you there? I had to miss it, unfortunately.
I was there virtually.
Were you virtually there?
I was virtually there.
Did you have a virtually good time?
Yeah. I was really focused on some of the stuff. Studio B is taking a lot more time, technically, for me to design. So, it's, you know, when you wear all the hats, it's whatever. You know, it's whatever. I do want to say we only have an hour today, so we're going to try to get as much in as we can. We do have tickets to the Texas Christmas Experience Santa's Wonderland in College Station. If you're going to be heading up there, as you know, on December 3rd through the 6th, they have a cool hayride that goes on in College Station. And we got tickets provided by Cadence Hope, who is the Proceed special charity ticket. So we're giving away these tickets. Cadence Hope is a wonderful nonprofit organization helping out NICU babies. So if you're interested and you're going to go to College Station, you want a free hayride, we got it right here, December 3rd through the 6th, and that's happening in College Station at Santa's Wonderland. I don't know about hayrides. I've been on one hayride, and it was too long, and there wasn't enough beer. So it's one of those things that, you know, I'm good to go anywhere, but not on a hayride. There's no beer. So, hey, Caden Hope, is there beer there? Let's see. Just kidding.
Are you brave enough to serve beer?
Yeah, we're giving away tickets. I guess we'll give them away all through the week. So, there we go. We are back. We're having fun. Hope you guys are ready for some Mornings Lone Star. We do have a couple guests, by the way, coming in tomorrow.
Woot, woot.
If you didn't know that, we have Jody Schreier. I believe she rescheduled for tomorrow. She wasn't going to come in on Monday, but they were scheduled tomorrow, and I believe they're bringing in some really cool different guests. They're bringing in different guests every time for Hope for the Holidays. I believe they're going to bring in, I'm looking it up right now, they're going to be bringing in Bonnie Schutz. She's the artistic director. Danielle Brasher, she's the choreographer, because you didn't know there's a lot of dancing.
There's dancing going on there.
I think there's ballet, too. And, of course, Jody will be in. That's going to be happening tomorrow at 9:30 a.m. here on Mornings of Lone Star. And then on Friday, which we are looking at rain, by the way, we're going to have Brianna Yancey with Champs Learning. So we're going to learn all about that. It's a local business called Champs Educational Services. So that's on Friday, but now it's just us. So welcome to Mornings of Lone Star. Boom.
Booyah. Well, talk to me about your Thanksgiving now, because we haven't been together since Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving was great, man. We sat with family, and then we went over to our family property where we all hung out, and the dog peed all over my bowling balls. That was a lot of fun. That was actually one of the funniest things, because we sat there and we just got done bowling. We went to the Del Mar Lanes in Houston with other family, and they bowled too. So I realized that through bowling and talking about bowling, I have other family members who bowl as much as I do. So my cousin and her husband brought their bowling ball, or he brought his bowling ball from Washington State to bowl with me. So we went bowling at Del Mar Lanes. Highly suggest, if you're over in that area, that's on 290 in Mingum over there.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I used to live.
That's a wonderful bowling alley. It's well kept. Food's really good. I had a wonderful time there. I highly suggest it. It is a little pricey if you were an individual bowler, but, for example, we got six bowlers for 2 hours for $40. And that's not bad because they had a buy one, get one thing. So I think regular pricing is $40 per hour. And that's not too bad if you have six people playing, because that includes shoes. So, but if you have like two people, it's kind of fairly expensive. But yes, we did that. So I took the bowling balls in my car, and my family wanted, my immediate family wanted us to come out to my brother's place. And my brother's place has a really neat little property that has the miniature horses and stuff out in a hole, which is by Liberty, Texas.
Okay.
And we get out there, and they were like, hey, I want to see your bowling ball. So I was like, okay. So I bring out the huge case. I have three balls in the case, and I'm showing it off. And then my other brother goes, hey, come over here. We got to get this fire. Can you help me? And I'm like, yeah, sure. And all of a sudden, I hear yelling on the porch. And I'm like, what are they yelling? Well, apparently the dog just walked up to them around while everyone's sitting around and just took a leak all over the bowling balls. So that was very entertaining. I had a good laugh at it because it was like an under, like probably 6 minutes of bringing the balls onto the deal, showing them, and me going over to the fire, which is not located near where they are. And it was like, oh, okay, we'll just pee all over my stuff. But outside that is what we did.
This is a lot more exciting than mine. We had a really quiet one. Mrs. Skippy went to go visit her daughter in Oklahoma for a few days. And so it was my mom and myself. And we decided to have a nice little quiet one. You know, we had some family deaths earlier this year. So,
yeah.
So we went to Denny's.
So why? What's the situation on your mom's mobility? Can we get her here on a morning show?
Oh, my Lord. She actually offered that herself. She's like, you should get me on your show sometime.
I would love to have
Mama Lord. Skippy in here. My mother is.
I'll get my mom, too.
Oh, God.
When's Mother's Day? March or May?
May.
May?
Uh-huh.
That's too far away.
Third Sunday in May, I think.
Are we past the halfway mark to May? No.
We're like right there.
So we'll look up the halfway mark to Mother's Day and we'll get them in.
There we go.
So my mom's a pretty interesting lady. So
my mother has the stories. Yeah. My mother is the world's most Jewish Gentile mother.
Really?
You know, she'll take care of you like the stereotypical Jewish mother. You know, when you call after a few days, you know, you haven't called for a few days. Oh, I'm so glad you called. I was waiting. You know, the kind of Jewish
mother
guilt. Yeah,
my grandma was the same way.
Yeah, but totally has your back. Yes, they would. I think your mom and
we'll
my mom would
that.
Have a lot of fun.
We'll work on that.
A lot.
So that's
of fun
good. You have food. What kind of food?
Well, here's the thing. We decided to eat out, and I was surprised at the number of restaurants that were just flat out closed down.
Oh no! I think it's going to get worse. I think what's going to happen with that is the restaurants literally do a campaign to advertise that they're open, and it's like that's their stick. It's like, hey, we're actually going to spend some money to let people know we're. Like, I think it's Denny's is the only one I kind of think of that's open.
Well, Luby's was, you know, advertising. Oh, we got a great Thanksgiving dinner, so we went to the Luby's, in, you know, off of I-45. The line literally stretched around the building. It was line.
Now, is that for pickup, you think? Or is that literally like we want to sit and eat?
They were sitting and eating. The problem was that people were in the line getting their food, but other people weren't in a hurry to leave their seats. So,
yeah, you're eating
so we
too.
Stood in line for about 10 minutes, and then we went to the to-go window, or the door, little room they have to say, well, let's just order something to go. And we're talking, we're looking, and more people like join us. Like, yeah, this is a good idea. We've been waiting in line for an hour or two. And we decided, nah, let's try Denny's. And so we went to the Denny's that I ate at. You know, Mrs. Skippy and I were in the hotel next to the Denny's in Shenandoah for 6 months. So I had said if I ever eat at this Denny's again, it'll be too soon. But
it was not
we
too
went
soon.
There. Yeah, so we went there. And I'm not dogging Denny's, and I'm not dogging that Denny's in particular, because you know they provided a lot of great meals for Mississippi and myself during our hotel days. But it was just the perfect storm of horribleness that day. They'd no salads because they only had romaine. So you know we're trying to order. Well, we don't have salads.
Right. There's
today.
An outbreak.
Yeah, the romaine outbreak. So okay, mom said we'll have soup. Well, the soup they gave her. It was like mashed potatoes. I mean, they literally scraped the bottom of the big pot. My mom's like, this isn't soup. This is gook. And like, well, we're making some more. She's like, well, okay, I'll wait for the more. She got the turkey. I was like, you know what? No, I'm going to go for a steak. And I like my steak mooing, you know, but apparently the chefs were upset because they'd been there all morning long and all day long. And the night crew was calling in sick, like across the board. So they were upset. So they took it out on my steak. So, you know how some Thanksgivings kind of blur together?
Well, I mean, like,
this one stands
let's
out.
Let's be honest. Wouldn't you say the morale of Thanksgiving, if you're not celebrating Thanksgiving, it's going to go completely opposite? So, if like, I think every person who has to work on Thanksgiving has a little grudge. Just a little one.
Oh, yeah. Nobody wakes up and goes, yay!
I mean, Holly worked on Thanksgiving.
Oh, I bet.
And she even said it was like, oh, it just stinks. But she made it. She had her first Thanksgiving with my family. Mm-hmm.
So, how'd that go?
Oh, it went fine. I mean, my family, they don't care. Yeah. It's like me, like whatever. And then,
do you watch the TV show Blue Bloods?
Yeah, that's a ritual for my mother and my father to watch that show because they feel like they had the mirror image of that family when we have our family things. That's what we do. And
so every episode we do. Features this big family, and every Sunday they have the family dinner no matter what.
Ours is on Wednesdays.
And they got the new gal in. The young guy is engaged to the gal, so she's being introduced to the family and having to learn their quirks and foibles. Yeah. So, was that Holly?
Yeah, yes and no. She felt like she needed to make something, so she made her family dish, which was really good. It's squash, squash casserole thing. But she brought a pie, and I was like, hey, I'm just letting you know, all the pies there are going to be homemade. So I'm just letting you know, though, don't take offense if no one eats your pie. And no one ate her pie. And she's like, yeah, you're right. No one wanted to, because it was pecan pie. And I'm like, yeah, my mom makes, my dad's favorite pie is pecan. Mm-hmm. So she makes two of them for, you know, the last.
No one even ate a pity slice of Holly's pie? Wow.
Well, everyone ate the squash, though, so she wasn't too upset.
Okay.
Well, and I think that's different because, like, I grew up in our family. My mother made everything from scratch. And that's just the way she was trained when she was young. Right. And so everything, like, that's how I learned how to cook, and especially doing pies and everything. Like, she does her own crusts and whatnot. But it's just part of the deal. On Thanksgiving, that's her deal.
There
and
we
then Christmas, we have breakfast together. That's the only thing we do as a family.
Yeah, we're going to try and expand our horizons a little bit for Christmas. Again, you know, we know this holiday is probably going to, you know, we're going to have to bull our way through this year. But Mrs. Skippy will definitely be in town. It was great to have her back on Saturday. She drove back, and we made up for lost time on Thursday.
It felt long, though, didn't it?
Yeah.
Did it? I mean, I know when it was – it's always the reverse feeling. You always feel like the Sunday comes too soon. Mm-hmm. But when it was like Friday, Saturday, I go, man, it feels like it's Sunday. And, like, I think I'm going to have to get up tomorrow. But I don't. I have an extra couple days. And it's like, I don't know what's going on. But, yeah.
So, yeah, so that was Thanksgiving. We got Christmas around the corner now. We're just mere moments away from December where we can, you know, where no one can complain about playing Christmas music at that point.
Yeah, I worked on the Christmas music for downtown, so hopefully today or tomorrow you'll hear it in downtown.
Awesome.
I it's funny because after a while doing that, because I try to redo the music every year for downtown to actually have some variety, but it's kind of hard to go away from Frank Sinatra and Andy. Is it Andy Miller? I just went blank. What's his name? He's a big Christmas, kind of like sounds like Frank Sinatra. Andy Williams?
Oh, wait, yeah, there's
Help
Andy
me
Williams.
Out. Is it Andy Williams?
Yeah, Andy Williams, Perry Como. Yeah. You know, you
like,
got all your crooners.
You really can't deter from that. And so, but I always felt like you need to include new stuff. You know, like what's the new Christmas music? But when you try to mash it up, you can't do like, two Frank Sinatra-esque kind of Christmas songs and then do...
The Hanukkah song by Adam Sandler.
Yeah, something like that. Like, you just can't. So I try to do, like, an hour of classics and then an hour of new age, kind of, like, alternative views on some of the Christmas music. Not hardcore, like, death rap, but I don't know if that's even a genre. Just made that
okay,
up.
Okay, no, well, no, believe it or not, I'm sure there is. I actually have this app that every holiday time I re-download onto my phone, and it's called Christmas Radio. And what it is, it's a an app that brings in the streaming versions of all these Christmas stations worldwide. In fact, okay. There's like one or two that are actually at the North Pole where they broadcast. And it's a lot of fun because you get to choose your traditional or your 50s or your classics or your modern ones. So I actually got a question for you because there's one Christmas song that whenever I hear it, I am filled with just rage. I just want to throat punch the person playing the song because it just bugs the snot out of me. And it's called The Christmas Shoes.
Okay.
And
I don't think I played that one.
Well, do me a favor. If you do, I will hit you. I will strike you.
Okay.
The premise of it is this guy standing in line, and there's this little, you know, orphan-type kid in front of him, you know, all ratted out.
I know what song we're playing tomorrow.
Yeah, I will launch myself across this table. But the kid's trying to buy these shoes, and the kid's telling the clerk, because it's Christmas Eve, these are for my mom. She's dying. She's going to die tonight. You know, dad says, get ready. It's going to happen any day now, any minute now. And I want her to wear these shoes to heaven. So, but the kid doesn't have enough money to, you know, he's only
to
got
buy the shoes.
To buy okay. the shoes. And so
did he get a job?
No. You may as well have for all the help he gets because the song, sung in first person by the guy standing behind the kid, is magically filled with a Christmas spirit.
Yeah.
And so he gives the kid enough money to make up for what he doesn't have to buy the shoes. He doesn't buy the shoes for the kid. He's like, what you got? What are you short? $5? Okay, here's five. He gives the kid, you know, just enough money to make up for it. The kid goes, you know, running off to
put
these
shoes. That's nice, though.
You know, at least it's something. They actually, I think Lifetime did a movie version of it with Rob Lowe. And I hate that. I know everyone hates Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer or Weird Al Christmas songs, but I'm telling you, that one is just the worst. So I have a question for you. Is there a Christmas song out there, and this is for the listeners too, that just rubs you the wrong way? And, you know,
I would say not for me.
Grandma Got Run Over by Reindeer's
one. I think La Vida Navidad kind of has that just because it doesn't feel like a Christmas song.
Mm-hmm.
The tone and just the way it's played. But then again, like they add bells in the background. I guess that makes it a Christmas song.
Yeah. More sleigh bells.
Oh, okay. I will say there is one song. It's a Kenny Rogers, Mary, Did You Know?
Okay.
And that's only because I think when I was like 9 or 8, whenever that CD came out, my father bought it and he put it on replay.
Oh, yes, yes.
But there's no other, like out of the whole album, there's like two good songs. And so I just remember hating that album. It's called The Gift, I think it was. And I just remember just despising it because I was like, man, I really don't care anymore. And because some people, that was back in the day when CD players were the only way to listen to CDs. So he'd put the whole CD on replay. And it's just like the whole time. And I was like, oh my gosh.
Well, sound off, listeners. Who, just what Christmas song out there just, and you go the other way too, like one you hate and one you love.
One I love?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I guess it's not a specific song, but I would totally dig the, like, you ever seen Home Alone 2?
Not willingly.
But you know when he ventures into the church and they're singing those songs?
I got to remember what they're singing. I remember the singing.
I don't know the specific, but I mean like that kind of music. Like okay. I'm totally digging that. Like I would play that in the house if it was choral music, choral Christmas music from a choir, from some well-known choir, or from local, whatever. Because I'm wondering if like you can actually go to a place here, around here, that does that. Wouldn't that be a way to get people into the pews? It's just like, hey, we're having a Christmas show.
Right. Well, a lot of them do.
Well,
like
that's Jody. Let's see
thing.
If they're doing a choir thing.
Yeah, there we go. That would absolutely work.
So, yeah. I mean, that's what I like.
Yeah, I like that. Well, I think my all-time just, I've got some favorites. One that just always gets me in the feels every time is a particular version of Silent Night or Stille Nacht done by Mannheim Steamroller for one of their Christmas albums. And it's beautifully sung. It's beautifully arranged. I mean, I love the song in general, but that particular one just gets me in the feels all the time. One that kind of caught me by surprise, as it should have, I can't remember who sings it. It's a country singer, female, but it's called A Child Changes Everything. Have you ever heard that? It's basically sung by a unwed pregnant mother and about how she's saying a child, you know, is going to change everything in her life. And then by the time the final verse rolls around, you realize it's Mary. You know, Joseph and Mary. and it's Christmas Eve. And so it's cool. You know, it's got a bit of a shtick to it. It's not, you know, completely memorable. But I like how it's effective in the message.
Horrible.
No, it's effective in the message. It gets the point across.
Sounds horrible.
Yeah, there we go. We'll tell you what, it's 10:19 on the dot. Why don't we take a breather?
We can take a breather, man.
Yeah, take a breather. We'll come back with news and weather.
Yeah.
And traffic if it's out there.
Yeah, other stuff. There's other events going on, guys. It is the 28th of November, closing out on the month. Don't forget, we'll be right back. We got till about 11 o'clock today, so we'll be right back. Lone Star Community Radio. Days of old.
Conroe Coffee is a local coffee shop located in the heart of downtown Conroe at 206 North Main Street, Conroe, Texas. Conroe Coffee serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner, along with other treats and coffee. For more information regarding store hours and delivery in downtown Conroe, Conroe Coffee is on Facebook or by telephone at 936-266-7632.
We would like to thank Conroe Coffee for being a supporter of Lone Star Community Radio and our morning sponsor with Mornings with Lone Star. Don't forget to download the Lone Star Community Radio app from your Google Play or Apple Store. Bring Montgomery County's community radio with you anywhere with your smartphone or tablet. If you are in the Conroe area, tune in on FM. That's Conroe's FM 104.5, 106.1. If you are on the computer, bookmark irlonestar.com as your internet radio station. A Lone Star Community Radio, broadcasting 24/7 from the heart of downtown Conroe, Texas.
Business office cleaning is available in the Montgomery County area from Clean Sweep Office Cleaning, with scheduled cleaning services such as floor care, window care, trash collection, restroom disinfection, and stair and elevator cleaning. Clean Sweep can service a business one time or on a regular schedule with daily, weekly, and monthly options. Clean Sweep Office Cleaning can be found online at cleansweepofficecleaning.com or by calling 832-689-7996. Clean Sweep Office Cleaning. Take back your time and let us make your office shine. Mornings with Lone Star is sponsored by Clean Sweep Office Cleaning.
Have a legal question? Are you a resident of Montgomery County? Call 281-645-6344 to talk to a volunteer attorney from the Woodlands Bar Association. We answer the phones on the first Monday of every month at 281-645-6344 from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. to provide general legal information and information about legal resources to Montgomery County residents.
Listen in Mondays at noon to hear Conroe news from local nonprofits, businesses, upcoming events, Conroe Park events, news stories, and information that matters to you with your host, Margie Taylor of Taylorized PR. For more information about being a guest, visit irlonestar.com/Conroe Culture.
All right, welcome back. Morning's Lone Star, Lone Star Community Radio, irlonestar.com, and Facebook Live at Morning's Lone Star, and of course our app, irlonestar.com. You know, all that good stuff. Broadcasting live from the LSCR studios, it's the 28th of November. Welcome, welcome. We're here till 11 o'clock. Our partners for today's show are Clean Sweep Office Cleaning, Bean Punk Coffee, and C3 Content Creation.
Very close. Creative content creations. Yeah.
Man, I'm never gonna get that. My dyslexia is just way too hard. It's all begins with C's, C3.
You can also say C3 memories if you want, because that's a new service
Okay. But we get it. So I know this segment, we only got about 30 minutes left in the show. We want to kind of catch up on some general news and funny stories. I mean, there's a cool video going on around about that guy with the hang glider going off, and then the instructor didn't hook him in all the way. So he literally hung on for dear life for probably 45 seconds or something like that.
Longest 45 seconds
and
of his life.
It was actually a very impressive feat of strength from that individual. But you were telling me something also happened.
Yeah, this is...
It's, it sounds pretty it's a extreme. Headline. Is there a video?
It's extreme. No, there's not a video of it. And, you know, we're going to talk about this headline, and it's just staggering. And some people may want to laugh because it's just so... It takes you off guard. But it does segue into having Jody Shar in the studio tomorrow because, you know, the hope for the holidays is about suicide awareness, suicide prevention awareness. But anyhow, in Rochester, New Hampshire, there's a tandem skydiving instructor. Who, you know, this is the guy that, you know, you go, you pay money, you want to go skydiving, but you don't want to do it by yourself. So you pay money, you go up in an airplane, and the expert hooks you to him and the parachute. And then you go up and you both jump out and he controls the parachute.
Yeah, I think
like that
you have to do it if you're not a normal, like you have to go through class, or was it? To become like a solo skydiver, you have to do so many hours tandem.
Okay, I would not be surprised about that. The first time I exited an airplane that was in midair, it was not willing and it was not hooked onto anyone else. I still flash back to that. But anyhow, the tandem skydiving instructor had decided to kill himself. And so they go up, he's got a guy hooked onto him and the parachute. And they jump out and a mile up, the instructor unhooks himself.
That's insane.
And lets go and falls a mile to his death. And that's messed up because it obviously it's bad enough to want to kill yourself and to go through with it. And then to do it in an obvious way that there's a lot of time. You have a lot of time to think about it on the way down. And you can't help but think, you know, halfway down, I see going, this is not such a good idea. But to knowingly jack with someone who is now scarred for life, you know, not bad enough that, okay, I'm overcoming my fear of skydiving by hooking on to this expert. But yes. Now this expert, guy I left behind, his reality is shattered because it's like you can't trust anything now. You go up to skydive with the guy, you're putting your life in their hands, and then they just say, you know what, I'm going to leave you up here.
Did he pull the chute before he?
Yeah, the chute apparently had been pulled, but the second the chute was pulled.
I wonder where, like, he said. You think like he turned around and was like, hey, man, I'll see you around. And then just kind of unplugged.
Well, here's the thing about skydiving. It's really hard to talk because you're falling at about 200 miles an hour before the chute deploys. And so beforehand, he's not saying much. But even what's he going to say? Hey, you know, when you land, bend your legs, you know, roll with it.
Talk to Jason about
so
that.
So that's just jacked up. Obviously, the family of the skydiving guy, the instructor, I feel for them, those he left behind. But I really feel for the guy who's just left dangling, literally. Yeah. That would just that would mess me up for eternity.
Yeah, that's a little off-putting. That is for sure. So.
If you didn't want to skydive before, now you really don't want to.
Yeah. Yeah, it's funny stuff.
So, yeah, hey, so no, don't hang glide. Don't skydive. Anything else?
I wanted to talk to you about, this includes Donald Trump, but it got me thinking. Mm-hmm. He tweeted out something about the CEO of GM. And
thanks a lot. We gave you $14 million.
Well, I mean, what's weird to me is, you know, instead of the delivery of the message, it makes sense to me that people are being aggressive on this kind of front in the business world. Kind of like how Google's employees are now coming out saying, like, I don't want to work for this company anymore because they're not following their core values. Mm-hmm. Especially, and the main reason this has been new is the CEO of Google, one of the CEO guys, basically talking about compromising with China. Mm-hmm. And offering their services to, but they had to compromise so many liberties. And because China's pretty bad with certain areas of civil liberties.
We throw around the
rights.
Word freedom a lot. America's free and it gets trite, but compare it to some other countries.
I wanted to tell you a story. I was listening to this funny comic. He's French. He's the number one French podcaster, comedy. I don't know. I can't pronounce his name. But anyway, he's in Canada.
Okay.
And what area in Canada is it? Quebec is very French.
Yes.
So basically, he made a comment about a kid who had cancer in one of his shows that wasn't like aired on TV. He just did it, and he got basically the human rights something in Canada basically fined him $80,000 for saying a crude joke about a kid with cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And he was talking about, you know, him going through the process of realizing how important freedom of speech is.
Right.
And how Canada has zero of that.
Mm-hmm.
And he said the worst case scenario is nothing written on what is right, what is wrong. It just depends on what the current government wants to deem wrong. And that's when he started being outspoken about, you know, we need to have established rules. Even if the rules are bad, we need to still have rules. Kind of like what Twitter. Twitter is under fire because they don't have the rules set on paper what you can ban you. And
yeah, it's very subjective.
I think there's even like a quote by the CEO of Twitter of like his reasoning for without giving the list because they feel like you're going to break the rule. You'll know how to break
if
the,
you know
the
what
rules.
You can and can't get away with. And that's the I think, the other
is
side
that,
of the story.
Does that remind you of like 1984? Where, like, they kind of do the way they think about solution solving and
well,
stuff
1984
like that.
Is government-based, and that's the whole thing.
They repeat things. Like, strength through unity? What was it, like, I won't blank on that part. You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. And they have, like, speeches, and they all repeat it to each other.
Right, and that's the difference, because a lot of people, some people are going, oh, we're heading towards 1984. No, actually.
Is that, like, doublespeak, though?
It was quite the opposite, because our government is... At this moment, I'm not seeing it.
No, I meant more of the reasoning behind Twitter CEO of saying the reason we don't release the rules is because it will let you know how to break the rules or bend the rules.
I can see that. I think he's talking. I think he's not. That's not the reason why. They want the ability to say.
But wouldn't you want to know the rules so you know when people are breaking them?
That's my whole point.
It's kind of like the argument about this whole racism thing. Is, you know, if we ban racist speech, then we won't know who the racists are,
mm-hmm.
kind of thing. Because it's kind of like you're at your own devices here, and if you're...
When a non-physical aspect of bad behavior, let's say, you know, racism, you know, whatever your mindset is, when that becomes the criminal act, I think that way dragons lie. And this is where I take a very unpopular position to a lot of people when it comes to, like, hate crimes.
Yeah.
Because, and this is my stance on it, and I know I don't win a lot of friends when I say this, there's an inherent danger with a hate crime law, because what that means is, you know, white person kills a black man. That's a hate crime because there's racism involved. But that lessens, to me,
the severity of actually
black on black killing or white on white killing.
Yeah, yeah.
Or so let's say, you know,
way you have to look at it too is, you know, the intent is always kind of important when you're presenting it to a jury who's making the
that's
guilty
up to
or
a
not.
Jury to so, decide this to interpret, but you know, that's where your motivation comes into it. But actually, to criminalize, you can't be arrested for a desire to rob a bank.
Yeah,
man, I'd love to kill that guy, or you know, I'd love to just leave poop on the neighbor's yard, or I want.
But if you say you
want
to leave
taxes,
poop on the neighbor's yard because he's a white dude or because of a race,
that suddenly makes it a criminal act. Yeah. And I mean, that's to me, I have a problem with that. It's Minority Report, basically. You can't be arresting people for things they haven't physically done yet.
Well, you heard it here, folks. If you're trying to frame somebody, involve a hate crime in it, and you'll probably get more attention.
There you go.
It.
And there's a wonderful play called The Laramie Project, which actually covers that. And if you've never seen it, it's remember the Matthew Shepard case, the gay kid who was tortured and killed in Laramie. And what they did, it's a playwright interviewed a lot of the family members and community. And then turn into a play where it's people just standing and playing these people and just word for word coming out. And one of them has, you know, talks about hate crime because the Matthew Shepard case started the whole hate crime law that, you know, to kill a kid just because he's gay makes it a hate crime. Now, my only issue with that is then technically all crimes are hate crimes. Let's say my kid.
Because I hated you because you said something, you slapped
my
kid.
That means that. My straight kid is murdered by people, but it's not as much of a crime because he just happens to be straight and not gay.
Well, what happens if I kill you because you are straight?
It's not a hate crime.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
You couldn't argue that at all? Like, I literally don't like the fact that you're straight.
You would
How's
have
that not
to,
a hate crime?
I don't think a DA on the planet would actually put it under hate crime. They just do it as a straight manslaughter murder case or whatever.
So what happens if a gay person kills a straight person because they're straight?
That's the duplicity. It's very.
Well, we hope so.
That's what I'm saying. It's who determines at that time what becomes a hate crime.
The world can be stranger. But no, the reason I wanted to bring up the GM thing is their stock like really kind of took a hit because of it. And I think
they're laying off 14%.
There are three plants being removed. Mm-hmm. And I think what I like about it is it lets the public know about something that happens a lot and there isn't accountability to it. Because a lot of people, I think, forgot that how much money the bailout was for GM and they're not even improving their product. And I think that's kind of funny to me. And now there's a world that we live in today where we have a businessman in the White House who's like, hey, this isn't right. You're basically, hurting.
Oh, we're financially hurting. Give us a bailout. Okay, here's your bailout. Okay, thanks. Okay, now we're shutting down. Now we're laying off all these people. Well, and there's no accountability. Where did that money go? Where did the bonuses go?
Yeah. I think that's funny. I think a lot of Americans will resonate with the president on this. I think there's going to be – it's kind of like the border issue. A lot of people – if you cut it down, like the most average person is kind of like, yeah, we kind of need a border. But then you can get into the details of like, oh, they're tear gassing people. I mean, I'm talking about the overall look at, the border question. The one thing that is surreal to me, I will say this, I did see like the live leaks of people with cell phones and doing it. Do you think do you think they all got together? I think it was like 100 of them. And it's like, all right, we're going to go 3, 2, 1. Or do you think it was just kind of like, oh, look, there's a crack in the wall right there. I'm going to go try to get in there.
I think probably a combination of the two because you're going to hit – they knew full well the media behind it.
I think this is what bothers me the most is, I mean, any person sitting there, even if language is a barrier between you and I know there's people with cameras everywhere. Mm-hmm. There's so many people surveilling this area either for media or for, border protection. Wouldn't your right mind thinks if you just run across this open area. The only thing I guess they were hoping for is enough people would do it that they couldn't control it all, right? Is that what,
plus also you get to be when I say the martyr, I'm not talking getting killed, but let's say you get tackled.
Well, I'm not that.
Oh, I'm the victim here.
I know, but still, it's like you have it on footage of you doing this thing, even if it wasn't a publicized event, like. I guess it's kind of strange to me to not think, oh, this is kind of silly, guys. Like, even though we've trekked across it, there's got to be,
You have to ask, what's the end game?
Why would you risk it?
You're going to get there. What are you
going to... Yeah, why would you risk all that work just to be running through a middle of a concrete ditch?
Well, there are 10,000 people to ask their motivation on it sooner or later, so...
Well, I mean, it's only like 80 people, though. That's what I'm saying. I was like, I wonder if they had, like, they literally went around the camp going, hey, y'all want to run over here? Y'all want to run over here? You going to go? You going to go? 8 p.m., 8 a.m., dude, this is what we're going to do.
Let's do it.
And then they did it. Mm-hmm. And then, I mean, because the not the official video, I'm talking about like,
yeah.
There's this great website that's called Live Leak, and it basically shows you the videos that I've been kind of like asking, where are the videos of this crazy stuff?
Live Leak. I'm going to look into
it's
that.
A very bad website, guys. I'm just letting you know straight up. Like, don't go, it's very, like 18 over, like some of the craziest stuff. They have all those videos from Ukraine when Russia invaded, so they have like, actual on the boots, like people, it's bad. And if you want to have a realistic point of view, that's a great website to kind of go.
That's the tightrope. Really, it's like, it's really graphic. You're going to have to, it's going to challenge
like they
you. They
had suicide bomber videos, and then it's like.
It gives you unedited, unadulterated news.
It's pretty extreme. So, but then there's also cool videos of like a bat fighting a python and stuff like that.
Yeah, I just got. Heebie-jeebies on that.
So you can. I'm just letting you know.
There we go. The border thing, of course, is going to have to be resolved eventually. These people, they either go back south, they get allowed in bits and pieces. There's no one answer to this. But seriously, if it's an illegal act, you're going to get responded to. And if you get tear gassed, you're not the. If you're committing an illegal act and you're getting tear gassed, you're not the victim. In my opinion. It's a proportionate response to. Now, if you have National Guard mowing down these people with machine guns, that's a improper response. Kent State all over again.
Yeah.
There's proper and there's improper.
I think what's strange to me is that iconic photograph of the newer one with the lady carrying the two kids?
Yeah.
Did you see the shirt she was wearing?
No.
It's like a frozen...
90, like the TV, the movie Frozen. It's like a 90.
Oh, okay.
But it's meant for like an 8-year-old.
Okay.
If you look at it, she has little fruffles.
Okay.
Where it's like sheer and it has the Frozen lady on it. I was like, I'm pretty sure I've seen a kid wear that. And I'm thinking to myself, what's going on here? Like, what's really going on here?
Disney, hire me.
Well, no, it was just, I mean, I want to show you the photo. Just look at it. Like, because when I realized it was a kid's clothing she was wearing, I was like, man, do they just, like, you think they would have other, she would have picked another shirt instead of a shirt that was meant for an 8-year-old. But maybe it was that bad.
Oh, I'll have a look on that. Interesting observation. I hadn't noticed that.
Yeah. We'll take a break. We'll take our last break. It is 10:40 right now. Morning's Lone Star. We got about 15 more minutes left in today's show. Today's show, stick around. We'll be back.
Business office cleaning is available in the Montgomery County area from Clean Sweep Office Cleaning, with scheduled cleaning services such as floor care, window care, trash collection, restroom disinfection, and stair and elevator cleaning. Clean Sweep can service a business one time or on a regular schedule with daily, weekly, and monthly options. Clean Sweep Office Cleaning can be found online at cleansweepofficecleaning.com or by calling 832-689-7996. Clean Sweep Office Cleaning. Take back your time and let us make your office shine. Mornings with Lone Star is sponsored by Clean Sweep Office Cleaning.
Conroe Coffee is a local coffee shop located in the heart of downtown Conroe at 206 North Main Street, Conroe, Texas. Conroe Coffee serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner, along with other treats and coffee. For more information regarding store hours and delivery in downtown Conroe, Conroe Coffee is on Facebook or by telephone at 936-266-7632.
We would like to thank Conroe Coffee for being a supporter of Lone Star Community Radio and our morning sponsor with Mornings with Lone Star.
For those of you who like your partners, your gumbo, and your music salty, well, we're here to help with the music. Julian Shea here, host of Lone Star Country Nights Thursday, your weekly dose of roots and Americana and all the music that makes this part of the country special. We stir in Western swing, honky-tonk, Zydeco, Texas blues, outlaw country, and put a pinch of red dirt, and then we smoke it over a slow fire. Then listen to the results Thursday nights on Conroe's 104.5 and 106.1 and worldwide at IRLoneStar.com.
Lone Star Boxer Rescue is a nonprofit organization serving Montgomery County and surrounding areas, dedicated to the health and well-being of the boxer breed. Lone Star Boxer Rescue is run and managed 100% by volunteers since 1999. Our main objective is to rescue, rehabilitate, and rehome boxers that come to us from many sources, including local animal shelters, owner surrenders, and strays. For more information about Lone Star Boxer Rescue, visit our website at lsbr.org.
A Lone Star Community Radio is looking for those who are interested in hosting their own talk show, with monthly and weekly slots available on Conroe's FM 104.5, 106.1, and on IRLoneStar.com. Start your own podcast, create your first YouTube channel, and be on TV. Contact Lone Star Community Radio online at IRLoneStar.com or call the station message line at 936-647-3776 to take your first step into the radio world.
Hispanic Chamber connections with Dr. Carlos Sanchez, president of the Woodlands Conroe Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, featuring event announcements, member highlights, and more. Tuesdays at 1 p.m., broadcasting from the heart of Conroe, Texas on IRLoneStar.com and Conroe's FM 104.5, 106.1.
Is there someone you know who is hooked on vintage aircraft? Follow the Commemorative Air Force and its fleet of World War II planes, including the mighty B-17 Flying Fortress, Texas Raiders, which is based in Conroe, Texas. Texas Raiders tours locally and all around the United States, offering the public a chance to put their hands on aviation history. What could be a more perfect gift than a flight on a historic B-17? Taking to the sky on the iconic bomber is an experience that will never be forgotten. For the touring schedule, reservations, or more information, go to b17texasraiders.org or call 855-FLY-A-B-17.
A Lone Star Community Radio is Montgomery County's radio station with talk, music, weather, and traffic for Montgomery County. Have a question or comment about one of our shows? Want to know how to reach a host? Just contact the station at irlonestar.com or call in and leave a message at 936-647-3776. Get involved with your community with Lone Star Community Radio.
Welcome back. Morning's Lone Star, IRLoneStar.com. We got 10 minutes left, 10:44. We got great shows on today, Lone Star Community Radio. But we will be back tomorrow with Jody Schreier with Hope for the Holidays. We're going to have the choreographer in the studio, and we're going to have some other important people who are involved in the December 15th show, so stick around for that. We were talking a little bit about the border, a little bit about all that kind of stuff that's on people's minds these days. But yeah, I mean, I think it's an interesting place we're in, especially with the access to information and finding the truth. The truth is out there. I've learned that through Mulder and X-Files. The truth is the best thing to search for.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, I think the general population of the world wants to know the truth, not, you know, some version of the truth.
Well, that's the problem. There's a, you know, if you've ever seen the play or heard the record of Jesus Christ Superstar, there's a wonderful line in it where I think Pontius Pilate says, he's talking to Jesus and they're talking about truth, and Pontius Pilate, well, he sings it, but Pontius Pilate says, "We both have truths, or mine the same as yours." And I love that line because it's true. You know, there's truth in the, I believe one thing, it's my truth. You believe another thing, it's your truth. There's no untruth, but the two truths don't jine up. So,
yeah, deep stuff.
Hey, 58 degrees outside. It's going to get up to the 70s over the next few days. It was thunderstorms the next couple of days, so be careful out there. It's funky. It's El Nino. That's what I blame. I want to talk about some local stuff before we get out of here today. So
I'm involved.
I'm hesitant to do this because, you know, the subject matter. But so Virgie Arthur passed away at the age of 66, Montgomery woman. I'm sure that name means nothing to you, except that it's Anna Nicole Smith's mother.
Okay.
So
why does that still even matter to me?
Well, yeah, that's what I'm saying. You know,
Anna Nicole Smith is a lady who married the older gentleman,
yeah,
right?
Uh-huh.
Like the really old.
Right, then, Marshall.
Okay. She's passed away, right?
Yeah, she passed away, and so her mother finally succumbed to cancer. So she's local. She's Montgomery, so, you know, there's the local slant to it. I don't like promoting, like, Kardashians or any people that lower the human experience, but personally, I think Anna Nicole Smith just did what she – it was almost like – what's that Reba McEntire song, Fancy? She just did what she needed to do to survive and actually succeeded.
Well, what's strange to me is no one can really tell somebody that, like, they don't enjoy their lives based off of, like, the outside view. Because mm-hmm. a lot of people, I mean, I don't really know what she died of, but I know a lot of people judged her, so.
Well, yeah, unfortunately, her son passed away of a drug overdose, and shortly thereafter, she passed away of a drug overdose.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah.
Was it fentanyl? Because I feel like that's, like, the number one overdose.
I don't know. It could
drug.
Have been a little bit of everything. But this is something that I'll guarantee to make you outraged. I don't know, maybe.
Well, good. We got
Lone
5 minutes.
Lone Star College, between 2012 and 2016, doled out $13.8 million of financial aid that it shouldn't have.
What do you mean? Like, they didn't follow the guidelines?
Correct.
Okay, so.
It was.
Is this like a Harvard thing?
Well, it was improperly through Pell Grants and other forms of financial aid.
So they gave it to people who didn't deserve it? Or
correct,
they...
who didn't qualify for it. These people don't have to pay it back. This $13.8 million. Now, this is only 2% of the entire $663 million financial aid budget that went out. So it's only 2%, but still 13.8, and people don't
have
to pay it back.
Like, do you think it was just like an error on the document that they've, like, didn't put the right check mark?
Or I was think it, there's going to be an investigation.
Or was there
into
actual, like, an angle
million.
Someone was trying to run?
I'm leaning towards the latter.
I have 43 cousins that need to get into school.
Yeah, because, I mean, that's a significant amount. And $13.8 million only being 2%. So I think the person doing it is saying, it's only 2%. Who's going to notice? Someone else like me is going, that's $13.8 million. Believe me, I'm noticing. What else do we got here? Go ahead.
Yeah, you go. You got it. you got it.
We do have some artistic events coming up or happening. So at the Crichton Theater, we got Glitz going on right now. It's subtitled The Little Miss Christmas Pageant Musical. I'm thinking it's going to be a comedy.
Okay.
It started last weekend. It's coming up, starting this upcoming weekend, running through December 16th. And tickets will be at CrichtonTheater.org. Or also the Players Theater Company over the Owen is putting on Seussical, the musical, starting December 7th, running through the 23rd. So definitely at the Crichton, we got a Christmas-themed musical, the Owen. Not as Christmassy, but hey, Seussical, I mean, fun for the whole family. If you haven't seen it, it's a great play. We have that. We did talk about Santa's Wonderland has a hayride going on. We got tickets we're giving away. If you're on me, here we go. We want to give away these tickets here. We're over here. Here we go. Look at that. What camera are we on? Here we go. And I'm going to sneeze real quick. Thank you. It's allergy season. So these tickets are available for the hayride on December 3rd to the 6th. You definitely want to be part of this. So let us know if you want a couple of tickets. We will happily give them away to you. Good news. A drunk driver's off the road. Travis Drew Klepper was given a 15-year sentence by Judge Patty McGinnis of the 425th for a fatality accident on Hardin Road last year. Because of guidelines, he's got to serve at least half of that before he's available for parole. So, sorry, Travis Drew, but glad to have you off the street. Do you know the Randalls? They're on FM 1488 and 242?
Yeah.
It's going away.
Good. Randalls sucks.
I love Randalls, but here's the thing. So, I went there with my mom because they're having like a closeout sale. They're selling everything. And it was
the cabinets.
Yeah, everything. But tell you what, it's only a few days left, but if you want some sweet deals, like 60, 80, 90% off your food and stuff, go there. It's I made out like a bandit. I loaded up on some stuff. I literally saved more than I spent, and I saved $98.
I feel like you're a victim of the commercial.
No, I shop I'm Mr. Coupon.
Yeah, but you think they always have coupons because they know you're going to spend the money, so they up the price.
Well, true, but even then, believe me, with the deals I get, even taking the foul into account, jacking up the price, because I have people tell me, oh, HEB is cheaper or Kroger's is cheaper, I still get better deals. I am Mr. Extreme Couponer.
I wonder what you would be like if you lived in Alaska, because apparently their upscale prices.
Oh,
like everything
God,
is
like
20 times.
Yes.
Like toilet paper is like $20.
Mm-hmm. I would not survive well there.
We also get paid more there.
Yeah, well, it all works out in the end, but still, it's...
You'd just be like, oh my gosh, who would buy that much for banana? Who would pay that
I'll make
much
my
for
own
bananas?
Toilet paper.
I believe
I'll
it.
I'll use the banana peels. I'll repurpose them. Commissioner James Nowak, Precinct 3 County Commissioner, last night had his Christmas with the commissioner, the big old event, Toys for Tots.
Yeah.
They raised $40,000 for that. So.
I'm surprised he wasn't the lone vote on not to do it.
I got that. That's pretty good. Dick's getting all political. Woohoo! But yeah, congratulations on that. And Montgomery County's Precinct 3 Constable, Ryan Gable, he's going to be offering his Cowboys Breakfast coming up on December the 7th at the Longhorn Steakhouse. And this benefits Children's Safe Harbor, so you definitely want to be a part of that. If you're an Oak Ridge North person, fair warning, tomorrow from 5 a.m. to 3 p.m., the intersection at Hannah and Robinson Roads are being closed. They're working on the railroad tracks there, and that's on a good day that you're stuck in traffic there forever. So they say 5 a.m. to 3 p.m., but anticipate if you're there at 4 or 5, it's still going to be going on. So do be aware. This is a public service announcement brought to you by Mornings with Lone Star. And bad news for Luis Granados. He tried to run for the Woodlands Board of Directors, and we talked about this where he had not filled in his ballot application all the way. He left a couple of things blanked, including his length of time. So they took his name off the ballot. Well, he's been suing. Well, Texas Secretary of State upheld the banning of him. And okay. So now he's threatening to take it all the way. So good luck in your battle there, Lewis. I mean,
I think it's going to be strange to be working in the Supreme Court. Because of how slow, or like necessarily slow, the justice system takes.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't get the hot off the presses kind of viewpoint of the situation. It's more of like, oh, yeah, I heard about this like 2 years ago. Yeah, I heard about this.
As it works its way up the road. Well, he wants to go all the way. My thought is he's saying that he wasn't, it said you must fill out this entire form, including these things, but he's like, and they were the questions about how long you've lived here, how long you've been a resident. And he said that someone else told him, oh, it's not that important. You know what? I think, why leave it blank anyways? My confidence is not high.
How often do you fill up that kind of form?
Yeah.
I mean.
Just, and ask more than one person. So there's
what
that.
What a weirdo.
I want to end the day on some funny headlines.
It better be good. Well, we got to get going.
Yeah, so. Here we go. Florida. Chanavette Wilson was in a Dollar General store.
Yeah.
Breaking copious wind. Man behind her complained. So she did what any self-respecting citizen should do.
Lady, too.
Pulled a knife on him and threatened to kill him. Important safety tip. Someone in front of you in line is breaking
wind. I can
see
Holly doing
just
that.
Let it happen. And finally, you remember how last year we had that Hawaii...
Yeah.
The nuclear bomb.
Incoming
scare.
Ballistic missiles.
Well, there's a gentleman named James Sean Shields. Hey, well done spelling your name right. And he and his lady, Brenda Reichel, are suing the state of Hawaii for giving him a heart attack. Apparently, when they got the alert, they decided to go to the beach and...
Oh, that's not going to work.
End life happy, I guess. And they said they were... There's this kind of a gray area about what actually happened.
What?
But he suddenly on the beach has a heart attack. They get him to the hospital.
What would actually you think happen in the court of law if someone committed suicide because of that?
Oh, that's a good question.
That's scary.
That would be. Maybe things we can talk about with Jody tomorrow. Jody Schreier with Hope for the Holidays.
Yeah,
in the studios tomorrow.
Tomorrow at 9 o'clock, we'll be live on our normal time. It's 10:55 right now. We got to be heading on out of here. Don't forget, we are still giving away those tickets to College Station Santa's Wonderland for a hayride and a sponsor of Cadence Hope, the nonprofit. If we're giving those away, if you are interested, all you got to do is just message on Facebook. That's it. That's all you got to do.
That's all you got to do.
That's all you got to do.
Can't make it any easier than that.
So today's show is partners with Bean Punk Coffee, Clean Sweep Office Cleaning, and C3 Creation Content. No, is that right?
No. But content, you're so close.
Content Creation.
Creative.
Creative
content.
Creative content.
Creation.
Great man.
No.
I need a script.
We'll get it to you.
I need to read it like 1,000 times.
I'm going to tattoo it in your forearm.
But thank you for partnering with those, you guys. And also C3 Memories. Check it out. Let's look it all up online. You're listening to Lone Star Community Radio. We will be back tomorrow morning at 9 a.m.